Thanks, Jack. With typical rock and roll fashion, you know, you can't start a show with, of course, 20 minutes of going behind and causing some suspense. And, of course, having your batteries die in your microphones right before the performance. So, you know, we get that out of the way, then everything is fine from there on out. Hello, everyone, and welcome to premiere night and evening with the Show Cards. I am your host. Thank you. I am your host, Andy Kirk, and I'll be taking you on this journey tonight. Tonight's festivities is a little bit of a departure from previous years. And years past, it's been a showcase of different choirs. And unfortunately, with the holidays and the way everything just fell together with vacations and everything, we couldn't bring you any of our middle school choirs from White Oak or Colerain. So unfortunately, they can't be here tonight. However, we're going to do things a little different. Being as it's a rock and roll themed show, we figured we'd mix up the entire formula and see what came out at the other end. So what we're going to do tonight is something that never happens in show choir. We never get a senior night for our seniors. Unfortunately, we go through the competition season, and when it's done, it's usually we hit spring break, and we're exhausted. That's it. So we end up seeing each other at the spring banquet. So we figured tonight what we would do is bring out our seniors and have a little question and answer session with them and talk to them a little bit about their experience as Colerain show cards and anything they have to say. Do you think that'd be a good idea? Good, because I really needed to stretch out this program, and it's the only thing I could come up with. After that, I'm going to introduce you to our new directors. I think a lot of you as Show Cards fans would love to meet them, don't you think? After we meet our directors, the moment you've been waiting for, we will have our Colerain Show Cards perform their 2017 competition performance. All right? But first, before we get started, a few housekeeping notes, of course. What we have here tonight is a licensed and copyrighted show. Now, what we talk about here on stage, that's fine. You can take pictures, record, whatever you want. However, if you do any recordings or anything like that, it's kind of a no-no. Waycross Media is licensed for this. It's all good with them. But we can't have anyone putting any of this on YouTube or Facebook or anything like that. So if you could, please refrain from that. I know you're going to get excited and some of you are going to take a few photos. Just make sure that those do not get published out on the interwebs, okay? Anything with live performance, if there's a photo or anything of your performer or anything like that, that is fine. We're okay with that. We'd like you to refrain from doing that until after next Saturday. That is our first competition. We like to keep a few things close to the cuff, just like every other show choir does, before we hit the competition circuit. And in light of recent events, we really want to keep things secret because there's a lot of competitors that think we're down and out, and they're going to be pleasantly surprised this year. All right. I wanted to take a couple minutes outside of this housekeeping notes just to talk about the arts within Northwest Local School District. Not only Colerain High School, but of course Northwest High School and our feeder schools throughout the district. We're very appreciative of all of you that came out tonight to support the show cards, and we'll see a lot of you during that competition season, and we thank you all for that. We thank you for donations of water and anything you give to the program. It's fantastic. I encourage you not only to support the show cards, but also support your other arts as well. Just to name a few that I wrote down, Winter Percussion. I know a few people, a few friends that are actually in Winter Percussion. Their premiere night is 2 weeks from tonight, 7 p.m. right here. Come on out if you can and support them. They would really like that. I believe tickets will go on sale soon, $5 in advance, $6 at the door is what I'm told. Back to the middle schools, Cardinal Heat and Tribal Tones, Cardinal Middle School, Colerain Middle School, and White Oak Middle School. Be sure to support them. Those are the schools that cultivate the talent that comes out on stage tonight. That's where all of these kids came from, so be sure to give them the support they deserve. Speaking of White Oak Musical this year, they're going back to revisit an old favorite, High School Musical Junior. Some of you may remember that. And amazingly enough, it is being directed by ShowCard alumni Pam McDermott. So I do not know the dates as of tonight, but keep your ears open and come on out and support Pam and White Oak Middle School. One other thing, I talked to Jen Gunther last night about the Colerain High School Musical. I do not have the dates for that, of course, but Little Women is coming this spring. So please come on out right to this auditorium and support them as well. One more thing, just to throw out there. There's a million people to thank from Show Cards, and we can't go through the list. We'll be here all night. When it comes to moms, dads, brothers, sisters, alumni that have come back to help. Even other show choirs have come back to help. It's fantastic. I mean, we've had some of our main competitors be here to help us with our show and get ready. It's fantastic, and what a great community that is. It's just amazing. But I want to point out the Northwest Local School District Administration. I want to thank them for their support of Show Cards. On the surface, throughout the past year, it may look like bad news in some cases, and it's not the case, all right? People are working tirelessly behind the scenes to help Colerain Show Cards get to where it is right now tonight. So please, without their backing, we would not be here. So thank you to them. All right. Right now, I'd like to introduce you to some kids that I've known for quite a while. I'd like to have them come out, and let's just have a little conversation. So if you'd please welcome to the stage, if you're listening, I can hear you guys talking back there, Josh Lakeberg, Ben Kirk, RJ Johnson. Madeline Knapp, did you get your makeup done? Yes, she did. You're beautiful. Ian Koo. Steven Lindner. Jamal Martin.
Give that to Josh.
Evan Siebel. Skylar Schroyer. And Jamie Simpson. Ladies and gentlemen, your Colerain Show Cards seniors. So, I'm gonna just put my notes down over here real quick, hopefully not cause any feedback. It's kind of like, Josh, this is like the Star Wars conventions that we've watched recently. We get all the cast out, and we ask a few questions, and so that's kind of where I got the idea more than anything to do this. So
yeah, it really feels like a Comic-Con panel. That's what we're all talking about in the back. So thanks for coming out to Comic-Con 2017, everybody.
Yes, autograph signing will be in the lobby after the show, right? So I wanted to kick this off, and I wanted Josh to go first. What we're going to do is we're going to do just a simple Q&A, and I won't lie to you, we've rehearsed a few of the questions, because we didn't want anyone sitting up here going, I don't know. So we've given them questions, and what they're going to do is they're going to talk about it, whatever they feel like with that, answering them, pass down the microphone. We'll get down to Jamie here, and then we'll go back again, and they can say whatever it is they'd like to say to everyone in the audience. Censored, of course. All right, Mr. Fisher's here. All right. So be careful. All right, so Josh, you will start us off.
Okay.
Josh, you've been at this for 4 years. 4 years of this at Colerain. What are you going to miss the most?
No, just
yeah,
kidding.
I knew you were gonna do that.
There's so much that I could, like, there's so many little things I could say that I'm gonna miss, but honestly, I'm gonna miss, no, not you, Madeline. I am gonna miss you, but I'm gonna miss everybody in general. I'm gonna miss the family connection that I've had for the past 4 years, you know. As soon as I was told my freshman year, you are a part of the show cards, I instantly knew that I was a part of something bigger than myself, a family. And that's definitely what I'm gonna miss the most. So, yeah. I didn't do that.
One job.
Sorry. That was the signal to get him to stop.
I like to talk.
Ben, hey, I know you.
I know you too. It's like related.
I know, a little bit. Do me a favor.
Yeah.
Can you tell us about your most memorable experience as a Colerain show card?
I mean, I guess
my first competition.
I'll just project to everybody.
My microphone went off.
Oh, it's back.
There you go, sorry.
Portsmouth was a competition. It was my freshman year. It was my first competition. But getting ready for that, it hadn't clicked in my head. I was like about to go on stage, and I was like, I'm really doing this. I can't really dance, but I'm doing this anyway. And here we are.
I will add a note to that. You couldn't even snap your fingers the year before.
You are correct.
RJ,
yeah.
How you doing?
I'm doing good.
You know, you've been, painting over this question all day long, so I know you've rehearsed well. What has your experience been like to be a show card? I know you haven't been here an entire 4 years, so it's a little different, but tell us about what it's been like.
It's been rough, but at the same time, it's been great because me coming in, I was literally afraid, not even thinking I was going to make it. And then when I made it, it was just great. And then when I was practicing, rehearsing, it was just, I had a lot of fun. I got to meet friends, make friends, enjoy what I love, singing. It's one of the things I got to enjoy. And it just, I'm really upset that I have to leave it. And it's just a great thing to have and be with.
Very good. Good job. See, you were worried. I told you it'd be fine. Maddie, a little different question for you. You kicked off last year's show right off the bat, coming out and singing a solo. It's hard to get on stage right now and just be an MC. How do you do that? What goes through your head? I'm sure people would like to know because, you know, it's like ice water in your veins.
I mean, the first thing that goes through my head is, like, what are the words? Because, like, they always, like, leave my mind right before I go on stage, but I make it. And then I think about breathing, because you have to be able to breathe. I don't know. I'm just comfortable doing it. I don't know.
It's just automatic for
you. Yeah, like, it's. I get nervous right before I walk on, but then once I'm there, then I'm fine. Yeah. Okay, bye.
Okay. Just so everyone knows, Maddie does have a solo tonight. It's not kicking off the show, but oh my goodness, you're going to love it. No pressure, Maddie. Ian. Hi, buddy.
Hi.
This is one of the more difficult questions, actually,
in all seriousness,
but what has been your most difficult obstacle to overcome?
Yeah, I thought about this a lot, and there were a lot of different things I thought about saying for it, but when we were in the room, it hit me that the hardest obstacle is realizing that this is the last year, and that, like, this is my last shot at everything, and it's going to be hard, like, leaving all this in a few months, but I just never, like, thought about it until now, what I'm going to do after all this. Like, I'm going to have so much free time.
Yeah, I think the same thing myself. Excellent. Excellent.
Do I take it from him now?
You can take it from
him.
I know you need special cues. It's all right. This is an opposite style question for you, Stephen. I didn't want to get you all riled up with your favorite, what are you going to miss most, but what are you going to miss the least?
Personally, probably the practices where I don't get home until 8:30 and 9 o'clock at night.
and then have school the next day and like 7 different papers for homework. Oh, yeah. I don't think I'm going to miss the show choir hangover that much.
I understand that as well. All right. Jamal, in your years as a show choir, tell me about your most favorite number that you performed.
I think my most favorite number that I have ever performed would have to be Show Choir 2016's Atom Bomb.
Oh, yeah.
Because Atom Bomb was just, it wasn't, you know, just a special song to us, but it was just so iconic to the show choir world in general. And, you know, it was just great to see everybody, you know, enjoy it.
Funny you should say that. The other night I was talking with Tim Kim from
really?
Loveland High School, and he said Colerain Show Cards should have destroyed Loveland with that closer. We should have never beat.
Oh, we know.
Very nice. And he said from his experience, he's seen everyone is copying the show cards with everything they can do with Atom Bomb and wild closers like that. So you guys should be proud. Evan.
Yes.
Evan, you got to be sick of me. I've been giving you orders all day long. Evan is my ninja crew chief, and he does a very fantastic job at it. So, Evan, my question is directed towards backstage and what happens behind the scenes and what everyone here, they never see, and what we see is a wave of disaster upon disaster that, for some reason, never makes it to the front of the stage. What has been your most difficult encounter in your ninja career?
I would say definitely the lighting system. All the flaws and
glad I could teach you that.
Especially the light board.
Yeah.
That was a horrible, horrible, horrible thing.
The light board was bad. When we switched to computer control, you love that, huh?
Yes, much better.
Just a note for the audience, so you know, there's a lot that happens backstage with ninjas, and one of the things you've seen in last year's show, and of course you'll see in this year's show, is there's lights going off, and there's going to be some special stuff happening, and all of that is happening because Evan is operating it. He actually follows the cues and pretty much plays the computer just like a musical instrument to keep up with the band and everything with all the cues. So, you know, it's not the main part of the show choir, but it's definitely a big support of it. And it's amazing to see, and you do an excellent job, I gotta say.
Thank you.
All right, Skylar.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm here.
Leader of the band, right?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
We're looking at this from the band's point of view, all right? So what has been the most fun number for you to perform?
For me, it's going to have to be Atom Bomb as well.
Yeah.
Just because the music was exciting, it was fun, and everyone had a really cool part no matter what. It was great. I loved Atom Bomb.
Very nice. I actually gave you a second question.
I know. I'm special.
I know. So I wanted you to share your favorite memory as a show card and a member of the syndicate.
This is back in freshman year. Everyone's all tiny. And we're all just sitting in the back of the stage while the singer dancers are doing something, probably cleaning choreography. Basically, we weren't doing anything. We were just hanging around. And no one's paying attention to Mr. Parks, but he's just kind of sitting at his piano, just talking to himself. So we go over and we sit closer and we're like trying to hear what he's saying. He's dramatically reading the lyrics of the songs to himself. So naturally, we all circle up around him and his tiny piano with like hardly any space, and he just starts dramatically reading the entire show to us as if it was a little story time. And we're all just sitting there laughing, and Kylie comes back to like tell us notes or something, because obviously we weren't paying attention. And she's like, what is this? Are you like a preschool teacher now? Are we not in high school anymore? And it was hilarious.
Good story. Thank you.
Best.
All right, Jamie. Out of all my questions, you're the last.
Lucky me.
So, Jamie, I had a difficult time coming up with questions for this, and it came down to you because of alphabetical order, you know. Not a slight to you in any way, shape, or form. But it is an important question, nonetheless, that people want to know. Tell us about the work that goes into being a show card, if you could.
Well, it takes so much time just after school, then getting back from competitions at 3 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the morning, because we always make finals. it's just very much on my back and like on everyone's back. Especially it's our senior year, and we have gone through so much this year. And it's just a lot. And if I'm not here, I'm at home sleeping, working, or eating. So it's just my whole life.
All right. That's good. Very good. I'm very proud of you guys for coming up here and doing this. This is very good. What I'd like to do right now is give each one of you an opportunity. You can say whatever you want. Well, I'm sorry. Whatever you think you can say that I'm not going to get mad at you for saying. And then, if there's anyone you want to thank, anything like that. So this is your time to freestyle and say what you want to say. Because we're going to be so busy over the next 10 weeks. So, Jamie, you will be the first.
Great. I just want to thank everyone right here. You guys have done so much, and I'm very proud of us this year. We've gone through a lot, and I just want to thank all the parents. The parents have done so much beyond what other years, and I just want to say thank you to all of you guys.
Hi. I want to thank the moms, just because they're always there for us, fixing uniforms, costumes, doing whatever we need them to do, like, just making miracles happen, and they're great. I love the moms. You're all my mothers now, so. And then, I want to thank Sam Jackson for teaching me how to play bass, because otherwise I wouldn't be playing bass for, like, this show, so thank you. I love you.
First, I would like to thank Ben and Steven for convincing me to join this crazy group and share in all the lovely memories during competition. And I would also like to thank my mother and my father for putting up with all my crap throughout the year.
I just really want to thank all of you for supporting whoever you came here to see tonight, because this is what, you know, they wanted to do. This is their dreams, and this is what makes them happy. So with all of you supporting them, that just, you know, helps them get through the tough rehearsals or when the leaders are down their back correcting them. So I just want to say thank you for all that.
I'm trying to think of something. And you,
what?
You take this one. I think it's something.
I don't know. I want to thank, like, all you, like Jamie said. Like, I feel like we always have each other's back, and that's really good for all of us to know that we can rely on each other. I want to thank my family, who's taking up, like, half of the front row. I didn't know this many of them would be here. I want to thank people that, like, I consider, like, mentors, like Peyton and Kylie and Ryan Mulvaney and all of them for, like, constantly yelling. And yeah, are you ready?
Yeah, I'll take it back. Okay, so I have a couple of thank yous. First thank you, I don't know, she's out there somewhere. Sophia's out there somewhere, Sophia Hamburg. Being probably one of my closer friends that I've gained from this group, and she's just so supportive. We keep staying in touch, and it's really nice. My mom and my dad, I'd like to thank them for being supportive of this group. They help out with it so much. And I just want to thank this group for existing. It's been a huge part of my life. It's actually helped direct my career path that I hope to choose. And it's exciting. I love this group.
I mean, I want to thank like everyone, but then that's going to be really annoying. Thank you, Mom and Dad. And if the rest of the group was in here, if they can even hear me, which they probably can't, I want to thank everyone in the group because they're my friends. Like, thank you for being my friends. I don't know why, but thank you.
We love you, man.
I love you all.
Oh, it's my turn. Well, I want to thank my family that came in today. I know it was kind of late telling you guys, but I still got it all done. And we all came, they came in again. But I want to thank everyone that's here today that's coming in to support us and watch our show. And I just want to thank, I don't mind being annoying, I want to thank everyone that's in this group, all of you guys. It's just great to be a part of this thing and have fun. It's just a lot of fun for me. I'm glad I'm here.
I'm gonna make this my first part of this quick. Thank you, family. Thanks, group. Love you all. If any show card alumni out there, could you guys raise your hands real fast? That's a good amount of you. Thank you, guys. You've built this group in varying years. I don't know where everyone is anymore, but I hope that we'll make you guys proud tonight.
That was good. That was good. You must have been reading my mind because that was actually a big part of what I was going to say. So, like Ben said, thank you to all the alumni that have helped build this organization. That includes, you know, people who first started this in like 2004, including the Parks. I want to give a big shout out to, I guess I'll do individuals, my dad for waiting outside for rehearsals to like 8:30 to take me home till I could drive. I want to thank my beautiful sister for even planting the idea of performing in my mind, because never in my mind did I ever think I could do it until I started high school. A big, big thank you, and I told you I was going to make you cry. I want to thank my beautiful mother for always being here for me, for, you know, pushing me to keep going, even though I've gone through some stressful moments through many years, and you know, she's always there to make sure I get on stage, make sure my costume looks good. If it doesn't, she'll yank me back, fix it, push me, and get ready. And then lastly, I can hear him coming on stage. So guys, I know you're back there. I want to thank the group that's behind me for making my senior year so memorable. That includes all of you guys, all of you. You guys have made this year so awesome, so memorable that at the end of the day, I told myself I'm not going to cry, but I probably will. So that's all I got to say. So, yeah.
Yes, sure. Bring it to Jamal.
Bring it to Jamal.
Jamal's got something real quick he'd like to say.
Okay, so I just want to say, like, to all of you, I would much rather have the year that we had this year, going through everything that we had gone through, than just have a, you know, boring regular year, because the stuff that we went through this year has made us a much stronger group, and I'm just ready to be a threat this season.
Well put, Jamal, well put. All right, I just have a few notes I wrote down just in case. Hello, there we are. Thank you, seniors, very much. We've seen you grow up on stage over the past several years, and it has been an honor to work with all of you. Good luck this season. And good luck in all your future endeavors. Let's give these folks a round of applause. I have a show to do, so if I could have my crew come get these chairs out of the way, and I'd like you guys to go get ready, if you would.
Is this
Thank you, Ian. Thank you very much. As they get these chairs out of the way, just a few housekeeping notes. I'm going to bring up our director and assistant director next, because I think it would be very exciting for you guys to meet these folks. Without further ado, as these kids get ready to go, I'd like to take this time to bring out an individual who's had to hit the ground running in just a couple weeks' time. He's done a lot of catch-up. He's already here, you know? Jeez. So they took that microphone. Okay, so we'll do this. Interestingly enough, this gentleman is a freshman at Xavier University. Music composition and Chinese studies, Asian studies. A alumni from Marysville High School, Marysville Swinger. In fact, those folks that went to competition last year and watched us, you know those guys that danced around in the motorcycle helmets? He's one of them. And believe me, you know, when we talked to him prior to coming on board as director, that was my main question I had when we first met him. How did you do that? So what I'd like to do is introduce everyone to our new Colerain Showcars director, Mr. Alex Wampler. Do you have a statement, anything you'd like to say to the crowd? Everyone's chomping at the bit here. Thank you, Alex. I'd also like to introduce two others to the stage tonight that are part of our directors. We have a new assistant director with us, Mr. Kyle Hudson. Come on out. Kyle comes from, he's actually a local, a former show card. He played in the Syndicate, is that correct? A graduate of Capital University, with musical education and performance. You are a music teacher, basically, right?
Well, that's the goal.
That's the goal. All right. Anything you'd like to say to the crowd? I mean, you're back home. How about that? That's great.
You pretty much covered it. I guess the only other thing I would add is I will be studying in a Colerain to seventh fellowship choir class. I am actually going to be teaching that class. So not only do I get to see them in rehearsals and competitions, I get to see them every day too. So that's kind of cool.
That's fantastic. It really means something to have you back with us in doing that and, you know, keeping the kids honest on their heavenly voices, as we put it earlier. Heavenly vocals. One more person I'd like to bring to the stage. He is our band director, and some of you guys have seen this guy around a few times. Miles, come on out here. This is the guy that keeps the beat. He's also helped manage the arrangements and get everything under control and get everything together for this year musically backstage. And a great person to have as the leader of the Syndicate. What words you got for us?
It wasn't just me. I had some help. Thank you, Mr. Barbara, for helping with the horn on. It's been a fun year. We definitely had our ups and our downs, and we're just so happy to be able to share our show with you guys. it's been a long road, so, and you'll see how much work these kids have put in day in and day out. Although I don't have the pleasure, as Kyle does, to see them every day, but I see them during rehearsal just growing and giving their all. So you'll hear it, you'll see it, and hopefully we blow you guys away.
Thank you, Miles, Alex, and Kyle. Much appreciated. We are so glad to have you carry on the legacy of Colerain Show Cards. Thank you again. All right, folks, it's showtime. I wanted to make one last statement. You know, get this guy off the stage. I want to see these guys sing. Just a few words I wrote about this group. They followed a long and winding road to get to this night, an amazing journey. They started with the unsureness about whether they would even be in an organized group last spring. They got to work later than anticipated in the summer and went through rehearsal after rehearsal to get themselves up to speed. They carried on that work ethic that they were taught by their predecessors throughout the fall. They hit a roadblock along the way in their year recently, but funny enough, these kids continued to work. You know, they kept everything together, even with the possibility and the reality of postponing the season and possibly shuttering it for the year. Other groups would have shut down for less. Not these kids. As I've told them recently, I've had to have a few pep talks over the past several weeks before Alex came on board and help them keep going. Every year has a fantastic story behind it. Last year had a fantastic story. It was awesome. I can't imagine what this story will be like this year, and I can't wait to see how it plays out. It is going to be so exciting. Once again, it's truly an honor and a privilege to work with such a fantastic group of kids. And before we go through the bio and everything, another round of applause for such a fantastic group. All right, here's the official stuff, all right? This is the stuff you'll hear when you go to the competitions, which, oh, I never even mentioned that. Oh, we got competitions. Next week, Piqua Invitational. Piqua, Ohio. After that, we're heading to Marysville, and we got the big guns up there. There's going to be a lot of the big show choirs there with us. We're not looking down. We're looking them straight in the eye, and we're going to compete head-to-head. It's going to be fantastic. We're going to work on this show more and more throughout a hiatus that'll get us to Hamilton, the Double H Showcase. I believe from there we'll be back at Loveland Showfest, defending our grand champion from a year ago, of course, as well as WH Showcase. There's a few others in there as well, and you know, I'd love to remember them all, but it's hard. I think Lebanon follows that, and then we finish up March 18th at Taze Valley. First time back in a long time, and that will be my birthday, and I want a grand championship, guys. All right? That's all I want. So, please, if you can come out and support them, please do. You know, we love to hear you cheer, and we'll hear you cheer tonight. So here's the official bio, and we'll get going with this. The Show Cards is an award-winning, nationally recognized and ranked show choir from Colerain High School in Cincinnati, Ohio. Made up of 62 students comprised of 47 talented singers, dancers, an amazing technical crew known as the Ninjas, an instrumental combo known as the Syndicate, led by percussionist and Colerain alumni Miles Elliott. Choreography is designed by Rachel Perrin and Peyton Bellman. After the retirement of award-winning directors Randy and Michael Parks, the Show Cards have worked through a transition period to finally meet up with first-year director Alex Wampler. Alex is assisted by assistant director Kyle Hudson. This year's show is Revival of Rock, and we've added a new piece to it, Revival of Rock, The Comeback Tour, featuring iconic rock arrangements from the past, including selections from The White Stripes, Red Hot Chili Peppers, Heart, Joan Jett, Thin Lizzy, David Lee Roth, Quiet Riot, and Poison. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you your 2017 Colerain Show Car! Thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for the Colerain Show Cards! Thank you very much for coming out tonight. If everyone has a safe night, please, if you'd like to, stay behind to take any photos with any of your kids, please do. We'll leave the stage open for you. Thanks again.